Well, there again. The week is over and the new week is about to start. Sunday night, I usually take a day off, but I'm afraid I'm gonna have to crack one. It's been a long week. So, the light. Switch to the light. I'll give you a second to grab one. I'll wait for you. Go ahead and grab yourself a cold one. Come on. I'm about to go over some of the clips you just seen and tell you a little bit about how my week went. Cheers. Any of you that sent me a couple bucks there in my PayPal or my Venmo, much appreciated. A couple cold ones, you know. That's how we do it. Thanks again. So, we started off, we had that Ford Ranger, you knew about that, and that was a gamble one because I didn't really pay up on that because it was missing a lot of stuff, you know, missing the bed and the door, and it wasn't really complete, but I gambled and the cat was just kind of hanging on there. It had that cigar, they call it, on that four-cylinder. And some of those can be really good, and you always hope that you could have that good one. But I haven't really got that huge score on as far as cats go lately. But just been kind of doing okay, a little profit here and there, not bad. But so we decided to weigh that Ranger up and cash the cat in separate. I couldn't have sold it complete because you know, it was missing too much. I mean, if it was just the bed or just the door, maybe I could have talked him into buying it complete. It did have aluminum wheels on it, but did that, ended up $100 under what I could have got if I sold it complete, but no use in crying about that because I couldn't have, and that was that guy's fault. He told me it was complete. I drove all the way out there, but that's how it goes sometimes, you know. But luckily, I paid $100 under what I usually do on it, so it still worked out in the end. And after that, got a little yellow Cobalt, bright yellow. I've been looking at that car. That car was literally, you could walk to the house where that car sat, right from me. I've been looking at that for past 3 years anyway, been up here. And come to find out, I knew the guy that lived there. I didn't even know that's where he lived. It didn't really look like anyone lived there, to tell you the truth, but the car sat, and he was going to do something with it, and he finally decided to complete car means everything in it, including the battery. No battery. Okay, well, not even going to bother to try to start it. I got my little jump pack, you know, little jump pack there, but whatever. So I start winching it. The rear brakes are locked right up on it. What a mess. The one on the driver's side started to turn, but the other one was locked. It was pulling all the dirt and the tarps and stuff that was on the floor with it. Big, huge mess. I ended up, the thing drifted sideways when I was winching it, and it was basically on the garage door frame hitting it. So it was a nightmare. So I ended up getting in the truck and I just pulled it out. And once I got it out, I had to start all over. And I figured before I start over, you know what? I'm going to put the jump pack on there. And I did that, and that thing started up, and I mean, it sounded good. Had 3.3. That's the good motor. And man, that thing ran good. It was pretty funny. After sitting in that barn for 2 years, you couldn't even hear it. It didn't even have a tap or a noise or anything. It just, no smoke. You couldn't smell it. So I ended up going back and forth, reverse to drive, trying to get that wheel freed up, and tire was spitting on the trailer because it was wet. Finally, I got halfway up the trailer and it broke free, and then I was able to just pull it on there nice and winched it down. I said, well, you know, there's another situation of gambling on the converter. I mean, I could have brought it home and messed with it and take the converter off, fill it full of metal, you know, play around. But the thing's junk. I mean, why waste the time? And those caravans, I also know because I've, you know, junked a lot of those in my days. Some of those can have some really good converters on them, but, you know, it's a chance. It's a gamble you take, you know. It might not have that. So I was just like, you know what, it's cold, it's rainy, I'm wet. You know, it's been a long day of driving all around. I'm already halfway down to the junkyard, so it's early enough in the day. I can still make it back there, and I just took it right back to him and just sold it complete. You know, I even talked to him for a second, and he said, yeah, he's not out to, you know, screw me or anything like that. Like, he kind of, you know, works with me, and he wants me to make out because, you know, I bring him stuff from far away. I'm the only person that comes from as far north as I do to bring him cars, so he appreciates it, and he agreed. You know, he said some of the caravans, yeah, but you got to get it off of there, and you know, and then you got to get the code off of it, and hopefully you can read the code because, you know, it's going to be all rusty. And I just decided, you know what, I'm just going to sell it complete. I thought about taking the tires off of it. I did take the snow tires out of the back. I'll sell those, but it just had steel wheels, and they were pretty nice 15s, but, you know, sitting on a dirt floor for 2 years, I don't know. Might be a little dry rotted on the bottom, and like I said, it was easy to just sell it complete, get my money, make my profit, and move on. So that was it, and it's been a long week. I've burned many tanks of gas in that dually, I can tell you that, and that thing is running. It's happier than it ever has been. I mean, it's just singing down the interstate. That 454 is running just perfect. cold as the Rockies. That's about it. Temperature's dropping, and thinking about heading inside. Time to get something to eat. Till next time, keep an eye on what's going on. Never know. Could see you on the streets.